Okay, so that's round four. Yes, I actually won a die roll. No, I would not like to play first. I want to draw cards. Oh, I finally hands. I still need a planes, but at least I get a pretty good start here. No, I would not like to mulligan. Okay, so he's playing red. It's gonna have Galvanic Blast, I'm sure. Really, am I drawing three fours before I draw a second planes? What's he got? Wall of Tangle Cord. Interesting. Very interesting. If I can go turn three Legionnaire and pay, and then turn four Tempered Steel, that's a pretty strong start. Let's see what I can get. Planes. Oh no. It was a little much to hope for, but laggy. Turns out when like 400 people are starting firing sealed events, system gets a little laggy. I mean, I wouldn't probably wouldn't mind trading Mirror Smith for Mirror Galvanizer, but he could just block with Wall of Tangle Cord instead of trading, and so that's just not worth it. Ooh, that's kind of intense. Pretty good draws. Still hoping I get a planes. Pay one. Not too much going on there. If I did draw, that's sad. If I do draw planes, I can Glissa Scorn the. What would I Glissa Scorn? I think Wall of Tangle Cord is what I would scorn. Gonna play out Suture Priest, just so that it punishes him a little more, and. Is. I think I'm gonna wait till his turn, but I think I'm gonna end up scorning his wall. He has a fair bit of removal, it looks like. Yeah, I'm gonna let that slide. The Trigon of Rage doesn't worry me until he has something to rage. And nothing this turn either. I think I'll wait. Okay, I can afford to pay just two life instead of four. And boom. Boom, shakalaka. Yes, I do want to gain some life that I paid. Suture Priest is really good. Like, that's gonna. We're running, in like 2 weeks, we're gonna run a six New Phyrexia sealed event at my local game store. And it's gonna be interesting now that I think about it. What's he. No! No! That's sad. At least I got that out of his hand. think. Do I just kill the. No, it's probably better if I just wait. At the end of the turn, I can put in a Darksteel Sentinel and go to town. Once I have the Darksteel Sentinel out, I can attack with the Legionnaire and. Oh. No, I can't. So, do you want it to lose life? It's cost 5. Like, zero chance that he actually attacks. Of course. Kind of thinks that there's really nothing. Okay. Well, Tempered Steel doesn't quite get anything above the range to kill these guys, so. Kind of think. If I Glyphs of Scorn, Tempered Steel, he probably won't block Mirror Smith. He'll take 3, 6, 9. And this would die though. So he'd block here. That'd be dead. And he'd take. So if you blocked here, and possibly blocked here, you take 3, 6, 9, 14. So he'd be dead in 2 turns. Yeah, so I think that's what I'm gonna have to do. Why did I do that? Why? Why? Oh, that was bad. That was so dumb. That was bad. Oh, tis the problem when you think, when you're very, very thorough about your plans. Oh, that was so bad. Oh, why did I do that? I don't. Oh, that was so bad. It's gonna take at least 10. If he has like Slice and Twain, I am so screwed. Okay. Don't know why he felt that that was gonna be worth it, but unless he has like a withstand death or something as well. Yeah, I figured he had that. And I knew he had to have some kind of artifact removal, but in this case, anyway, he's gonna have to block the Darksteel Sentinel with the Rotted Hystrix, and the Galvanizer will probably trade with one of the mirror, and he'll take 9 damage. Really, he's gonna take 12. That's. But now, like, him playing a blocker could just kill him. No, him playing a blocker wouldn't kill him. But. So that's tough. He gets to attack me, but he's gonna take 7. Does he have removal? I mean, I can block too, like, so it doesn't even matter. Okay, he kills one of these guys, takes 4. Not even a concern. So, don't know how he thinks he wins here. Changing now, this is like nail in the coffin. Because if he does, like if he doesn't block the Darksteel Sentinel, he just dies. Like there's no block for him. Maybe if he has Gutshot, but he should have used Gutshot already. And that would put him in a position where he could just die anyway. Ooh, those. Oh man, I almost screwed up so bad with that. I really did screw up bad with the Glissa Scorn and the Tempered Steel. Give him extra draw steps. That was bad. That was bad, 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 bad. No. So Horde Smelter Dragon doesn't save him because now he played a blocker and he's down to one and he doesn't have. This was. Oh. If he actually watched my videos, he'd be like, I can't believe I lost to this dumbass. Okay, and time to win. Because he blocks here, takes one, dies. Very high toughness. It's definitely some a very interesting blind Zilla. Could become a little bit better, but the fact that it's double black hurts too much. It's very, very interesting choices here. He has a lot of high cost things, so if there was like discard I could use, I might be winning too. Galvanizer, Wall of Tangle Cord. So there's a few artifacts. This might be the match where it's better to bring, like, since he had high toughness stuff, it might be better to bring in the red over the black. And yeah, because this deals with Horde Smelter Dragon, deals with the Quarter Shield or Trigon of Rage or whatever I needed to. Yeah, I think this is better. Not sure about Leeching Bite because I could put in the Apostle's Blessing. Don't know. I'm not sure that that would be the right call at the end. So very, very interesting situation there where I had almost all my forests before I even had two planes. And I think the fact that Arterialize deals with his Horde Smelter Dragon might just be what I needed. So not a lot of things I'd want to sacrifice, but can't say there's nothing I like. I can always make copies and stuff, so.